Are you okay? That was a nasty hit. Turn the engine off and wait for the marshals.
Incredibly disappointing. How will not making Q3 affect your strategy tomorrow? How do you feel the competition is for you this season? Appreciate your time.
We're back once again beside the St. Lawrence River here in Montreal for the Canadian Grand Prix. The event first moved to a variant of this track back in 1978. It was won by none other than Gilles Villeneuve, the first Canadian to ever win his home race, and in whose honour, the circuit would be renamed. With top speeds of around 210 miles per hour heading into the overtaking opportunity of turn 13, the 2.7 miles of the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve are some of the quickest on the Formula One calendar. There are 14 corners in total, with 60% of the lap taken at full throttle, and average lap speeds clock in at about 130 miles per hour. Anthony Davidson joins me once again in the commentary box. Ant, it's fantastic to have you with us here today, but I'm curious, as a man with experience out on the track, how do you stop those pre-race nerves from becoming overwhelming when you're lining up on the grid?
But from the moment qualifying's over, you start to feel the adrenaline in your body build up and the buzz in your stomach as you anticipate the rundown into turn one. It's all a bit like going into battle, and the unknown situation makes you nervous. Those pre-race nerves are a good thing. The day you don't have them means that you don't care anymore. And of course, you have to make sure that all the procedures are second nature to you so that they're not taking up too much of your capacity.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Lewis Hamilton lines up on pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Leclerc, Gasly, Carlos Sainz, and Perez, Ricciardo, Norris, Stroll, and Sebastian Vettel, Ocon, Russell, Max Verstappen, and Giovinazzi, Raikkonen, Tsunoda, Mick Schumacher and Nicholas Latifi, Mazepin and more. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track.
After the points finish last race, let's aim to keep the momentum going. Thank you. nice work. You did well today. I think the boss will be happy with that one.
That's it then for another magnificent Canadian Grand Prix, and they've hung on to take a sublime victory here today. Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today. What set them apart from the rest?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
So after a magnificent race, we can now see the drivers making their way to the podium. Once again, it's the Silver Arrows who take top spot, a well-earned victory for Mercedes. Driver standings. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. Some amazing talent out on the track today, but Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. There was a lot going on all down the field, but they were the only one who I really felt maximized their potential.
It's time to see how things are shaping up in the Constructors' Championship. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for the next one.
That. You made it look easy. You really cut your way through the field today. What was your strategy? Things looked close between you and your rival for a bit, but you came out on top, didn't you? Your team must be ecstatic with how you're performing. You left a lot of paint on the walls today. Were you struggling for grip, or did you just misjudge some corners? Appreciate your time.
You're not currently in a rivalry. Sooner or later, you'll probably be asked by the media who you consider to be your rival. Think carefully who you select, as while you will receive a claim for beating them, you'll lose a claim if you fail to do so.
Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix.